Tonight, should I say. Yeah. Mel Moore, Michael Stanley. Got it right. Yeah, they're going to be, as I say, sleeping rough on the streets of Devon tonight to, again, highlight the work done by soldiers off the street. So that's all coming up. The telephone line is open. It is live. Anybody wants to give Sapper Ken a bell? The telephone number is on the Facebook page. That's Facebook at Veterans Radio Net. It's in the pinned post. You can find it there. I'm going to go to, and I've got this one right. Can't get this one wrong. This track is a little more gentle than the last one. This is Glenn Campbell and the Wichita Lineman.
I am a lineman for the county, and I drive the main road, searching in the sun for another overload. I hear you singing in the wire, I can hear you through the whine, and the Wichita lineman is still on the line. I know I need a small vacation, but it don't look like rain. And if it snows, that stretch down south won't ever stand the strain. And I need you more than want you, and I want you for all time. And the Wichita lineman is still on the line. And I need you more than want you, and I want you for all time. And the Wichita lineman is still on the line.
My apologies, that is not the version of Bat Out of Hell I wanted to play there. That's the 10-minute version, and I'm not going to take 10 minutes of her time on the one track, not at this point of the day. I'll find another version of that later on. Okay, right, to those that have just joined us up again at breakfast here in the Naffy, good morning to you. Hope you're doing okay, and... Well, whatever you're doing, we've got to be better placed than Les Standish and Mark, who are sleeping rough, or slept rough last night on the streets of Chester. with any luck, they were in the doorways of the cathedral, but that was the plan anyway, but it was still going to be cold. And tonight, they're on the street again. I saw Mel and Michael down in Paignton in Devon, and it's going to be the coldest night of the year thus far. Not only that, it's likely to be one of the noisiest nights of the year. The 5th of November, bonfire night. And, yeah, that's going to be a problem for a lot of former forces personnel. It is a problem. It will be a problem. I know in the past few days I've spoken to a couple of veterans on the phone who are already suffering. Bonfire night, it's one night a year. But as we know, people are throwing fireworks around, setting them off all over the gaff for at least 2 weeks, a week either side of tonight. It's not right, but there you go. I personally would ban the sale of fireworks to the general public. And if they don't want to ban it, I would restrict the sale to a very, very short time period. Maybe just 2 or 3 days before the 5th of November. Try and force people to encourage rather than force. Try and encourage people to attend organised and properly managed events. But that's Sapper Ken's £2 on it. Anybody want to give their £2 on it, they are more than welcome to contact me. You can do it on the chat board. That's open, it's there. Do it on the chat board, or you can get in touch with us via Facebook. That's Facebook at Veterans Radio Net, or Facebook at Sapper Ken. Or you can call me and go live on air. Telephone number, if you've got a pen handy, grab your wife's mascara. All right, she might bat you around the head for it later on, but are you ready? The telephone number is 07736444289, and I'll give that number out a little bit later on. Right, as I say, that was a 10-minute Meatloaf track. I've got another Meatloaf track here. It's only half of it. This is 2 out of 3. Ain't bad. It will be once I put the slider up and turn the volume up. You'll be able to hear it then. That'd be a bonus, wouldn't it?
Nothing left inside of me, and maybe you can cry all night, but that'll never change the way that I feel. The snow is really piling up outside. I wish you I poured it on and I poured it out.
snoring.
Hello, this is Rodney Collins. I've just nipped into the Peter Haynes Show to ask you to join me twice a week here on Veterans Radio Network. Check the schedule page for the days and the times and join me, Rodney Collins, here on VRN.
You're listening to Veterans Radio Net, around the UK and the world.
Good morning, Peter. How you doing, young sir? Hope you're fit and well. And good morning to those that have just joined Sapperken in the breakfast show here at Veterans Radio Net. Now, Ian, you've had a bit of a rant. Absolutely fantastic, mate. Our mate Ian lives over in Denmark. He is a British veteran, he is a gentleman of the Corps of Royal Engineers. He is an old sapper like myself. And we'll be talking about fireworks because it is bonfire night tonight. And Ian's put, Ken, it's all about money. Yep, isn't everything. If a shop has fireworks for sale longer and before another shop, the profits are up. He says, but we don't have Guy Fawkes over here. No, that is a particularly a British thing, Guy Fawkes. But massive fireworks on December 31st over New Year. Yep, no problem with that. There is a ban that no fireworks after the 8th of Jan, but no before ban. So people say, the law says people can't use fireworks after the 8th of Jan, but they don't give a date where they can start using them. So doesn't that sort of negate the ban? Because if there's no before ban, I mean, if they said before December the 29th,